Hello everyone and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel. Finally I got a video. It's been a while. Now I got some field welding. I gotta cut that 8-inch. We gotta put two flanges in and a spec blind in the middle. I kind of support it with a chain fall here. We're gonna cut off the dead weld and do prep. Once the both sides are prepped, the welding procedure calls for a PT. Once the PT is done and everything is okay, we're gonna tack two flanges. So the prep is usual, feather edge. I always go at least inch from that edge. Like to use a carbide bit on this one, especially because it's existing pipe. You want to get rid of all impurities inside. As you know, once you start, when the dead pipe start boiling, it's gonna just put all that impurities in your weld, and it's gonna be a little bit harder for you to manipulate that puddle. Gap 5/32 to tight 1/8, loose 1/8. I just bridge it with TIG wire. I didn't use any bridge rod. Nothing fancy here, just x-ray both joints. That's 100% x-ray. It was supposed to be the hydro, but it's really hard to put that carver plug, so we gotta x-ray both joints. So for the root, 1/8 ADS D2, you're gonna preheat up to 200 before I start welding. And for the root, I'm gonna do back feed, especially on the bottom part. You want to start really nice solid. Keep the rod inside like couple mils, 3-4 mils inside that edge. And for the setup, Miller machine, XMT, 150 torch, nothing fancy. Cup size 8 and tungsten. I'm using lanthanated tungsten. So you know, I get rid of all the toriad I had used before. I'm not using it anymore. Although due to all those safety hazards, health hazards. As I said, start on the bottom. That's the most important part in any pipe welding. I always go up. I know you, lots of guys, you got lots of questions even watching. I think you don't, many of you, especially beginners, don't understand. As a back feed, you want to keep it above that edge on the top of your puddle. Just keep it, be consistent, just try to keep that rod inside. You got to be careful with that tungsten inclination. You don't want to, if you put a little bit upper angle, then you're going to burn that rod. It's going to stay cold stubs you're going to have. That's why you got to like burn on the bottom of that rod and just keep it inside. Don't try to like try not to lose any connections with your puddle. And that's the solid root I got, and I like it like that. Once you got solid root, you don't have to be worried. As I said, all my videos, no sock bag, guys. Don't have to worry about any sock bag. You can run really hot on your hot pass. As I'm using ADS D2 filler wire. It's not like 70S6, not that clean. This is our welding procedure with our company. We don't have 70S6 rods or 70S2. This is all we use for carbon. Welding procedure calls for preheat the pipe minimum 200 prior to start welding. All stop starts, as it's a hard pull, it's not a remote control torch. I always like to grind a little bit stop starts before you start. You always want to preheat a little bit, like I shown in this video. Preheat, wait till starts melting, then you add rod and just keep that rod, keep it consistent. Try to have that constant feed. Lower your amps. Right now I'm running on the bottom part. I was going like 125 120. Once you go up to 9 o'clock, then you can I don't know if did I mention, but I was freehanding the bottom part all the way up to 8 9 o'clock. Then I switch that, just lean nozzle inside the bevel, and then if it's too hot for you, you can always reduce amperage. You can go 115 on the side, As you can see, it's a different pattern. This is freehand the bottom, and then you can see at the top, it's way nicer, way cleaner. It's just different inclination, you know, more control. Okay, now the top part, I'm just going to leave that window up on the top. As I said, this is a closure weld, weld procedure. It requires a window to stay open so the QC can inspect root, and after on the root pass is done, they have to do MT. Okay, so for the top part, I just like to dab it side to side, stretch that puddle. As I said, if you're new to my channel, dipping technique is one of the best technique to pass X-ray. You're not gonna fail. You can control the amount that you actually depositing in your root. So you got control. You can clearly see both edges on the both sides. For a lay wire, you know, requires a little bit more experience, more technique, but with the dipping technique, you're not gonna fail, that's for sure. So I'm gonna just buff it, run a buffing wheel all the way around and wait for the empty guys. They're gonna do empty and everything is okay. So empty is good. So I'm just gonna go up 160. Right now my machine is set up 250 amps. So on remote, it's around 160 amps. Just gonna put a hot pass, that's it. Hot pass is done. Now I'm gonna do fill. It's nice and clean. Make sure if you got any impurities, you know, or if you dip your tungsten a couple times, you want to stop right away. You know, take a grinder, take it out. You don't want to have any tungsten inclusion. As you can show on an X-ray, you know. Keep it clean. Clean each pass. Run a buffing wheel. I'm just going to fill to flush after my hot pass. One pass fill. I slow down, as I said, 160 amps. Melts really nice. You can really stretch that puddle. That's it. It's fill to flush. Now we're going to cap it. For cap, I'm going to go up to 200 amps. Even though my torch is only 150, but you know, I'm gonna do a little bit and then I'm gonna cool it down a little bit of weight. Still, same cup, size 8. Keep it really sharp, your tungsten, especially for the cap pass, for capping. You got better control when you're melting that rod, better control of stretching that puddle. Try to be consistent in your steps, it's gonna look nicer. And it's clean, that's most important thing here. As I said, both joints are X-rayed. The good thing about TIG as well, it's you can always see what's happening in your puddle. If you got any porosity, it'll show you right away. And that's it for the cap. So this is one side, I'm gonna cap the other side, and I'm ready for X-ray. And that's it pretty much. As I said, it's been a while since I was had something to weld in a field. I've been on different assignments, different projects. And that's it pretty much, guys. I hope more weld is coming, more videos are coming, so I can show you what's going on, what's happening in the field. I hope you like this video. Hope you learned something. And you gotta burn to learn, guys. There's no other way around. Thanks for your support, for your patience, and see you in the next one, guys.